15 long.
I suppose what you need to look out for is Nadal tossing that ball a little further to his left. Slightly more forward. The most powerful serve there, 105 miles an hour, but adorned with all manner of spin. That was a can opener.
Carlos Moya, the rest of Team Nadal.
This is Mark Lopez, who joined the team at the start of the year. He's a great buddy from the junior days. I'm a player, of course.
They won the gold medal doubles together. Brazil.
Is that?
That was pretty good, because Nadal's wrist was hurt. He didn't play his best singles, but he stayed in the dubs to help Mark Lopez get Olympic gold.
Lazy.
You won the next doubles with your good mates that you grew up with here in New York.
First game.
John McEnroe.
That guy, whatever happened to him? He's really, no one hears from him anymore.
Yeah. That must have been pretty cool though, Mary. Someone that you'd known from such a young age, and then to share such a big stage and such an awesome event with, win it. That's pretty cool.
Well, let me ask you, talking about lefties, is there a bigger, name to me the lefties who have played with the most lefty outfielder. I mean, Nadal's got to be in there, right?
Yeah.
Martina?
Yes.
Jimmy Connors? I don't think so.
Because it was quite flat to strike, wasn't it?
Exactly.
Yeah, so.
Villas? Labor?
Villas more so than Labor.
That's what I think.
Yep. Labor wasn't bad, right?
No, he was pretty snappy. I'm just talking about using your leftiness best.
Yes.
I'm putting this guy up at number one.
Oh, yeah.
Francis Tiafoe to serve.
McEnroe was pretty good too. Tiafoe serves for the first time.
wait for the response to the backhand corner.
Long. Tell me about Wayne Ferreira. You have to have known him a long time.
Well, same age as Wayne. Grew up playing juniors together. I've known Wayne since he was 14 years of age. And just a superb human being. He's got a very good tennis IQ. What an athlete that guy was.
Mm-hmm. Fast. He's done a lot with Tiafoe. Mm-hmm.
It's two things he's really focusing on. One is trying to make Francis really concentrate during practice sessions and work on his focus, because he has these lapses in matches, and he thinks it's a byproduct of the way he practices. The more he can practice good focus and concentration, the more it's going to carry over into matches. That being number one. Okay. Number two, the serve. Doesn't like it when Francis is just happy to roll the serve, and he wants him to go for it, even if he makes a fault on the first. Because he's got a good serve, he's got plenty of power. And he wants him to use it to end the point, or at least put him in a very good position thereafter.
Love hold. That should make Wayne Ferreira pretty happy.
It was one a summer on. Of hard knocks, as I mentioned at the start. Of course, got beaten quite badly by Jensen Brooksby in Atlanta. Then remember the 5 match points he had against Nick Kyrgios in the quarterfinals in DC, playing in his own backyard there. That was an important result for me, because it showed me the level that Francis is playing at, what he's capable of. So close to beating Kyrgios there.
Flat for service.
As if that wasn't enough for Francis.
15 love.
He goes up 4-love in the third set against Taylor Fritz in Canada and completely capitulates. Ends up losing that one. I think it was a big wake-up call for him. He's coming here all guns blazing.
That's a good sign. Rafa's boxer's dad and his sister have come in for the second week. They were absent in week one. Rafa and his wife are expecting their first baby this fall, and she's been hospitalized of late. As if Rafa needs more worries with his injuries. Just before the tournament started, Rafa put out on social media, excited to be in New York, everything is better.
30, 15.
So again, to see that his dad is here and his sister has made the trip for week two, also suggests that they think Rafa's going to go far.
Only show up for the second week, right?
Yeah, exactly. Exactly. Take your sweet time.
Famous faces in the house.
There we go.
And Stella loves his tennis, doesn't he?
Loves his Rafa.
Yeah.
That's his favorite by far. At Indian Wells, you see this guy all the time as well.
I saw him having a hit with Diego Schwartzman.
Oh, really?
Yeah. Here at the US Open, I think it was.
Game. Nadal. Nadal leads by 2-1 first set.
You know, we're about to interview him.
Thank you.
James Brother Thomas talked to Tiafoe's father, whose name is also Francis.
Love lifting.
So Thomas Blake said to Francis's father, how do you say the name? And he said, Tiafoe. And then he said, actually, it's kind of a French-sounding name. It's more like Tiafoe. Something like that. Which wasn't going to be easy. So 15. James, I said, are we going to go with that? And James said, look, his nickname is Big Foe. We can't start calling him Big Foie. That's how Tiafoe came about. We had to settle on it. And Big Foie doesn't have that same heft.
No. Not enough to have a test. Certainly not nearly as intimidating.
13-15.
Would make an interesting necklace. And there is Team Tiafoe. That's his dad in the front, on the left, and his mom in the middle. They're from Sierra Leone. You've probably heard the story about his parents escaped all the war and cruelty of that country, made their way to the U.S. Francis's father helped create the tremendous tennis center there. Francis and his brother started playing when they were little kids.
Twin brother as well. That was a good
point.
All three, 13.
Sometimes the kids would stay with their dad because he had such long hours. 135, yes. And they'd sleep in. They'd sleep on the massage tables at night. They wanted to stay around, stay with their dad. Francis started seeing all those talented kids playing there. Tiafoe's strokes could look a little bit homemade. It's because he was a little kid. He wanted to play, he saw all these other kids playing.
Perfect.
So he would borrow rackets or find rackets that had been thrown out, you know. Borrowed rackets at the pro shop. And so every time he'd hit against the wall, he'd be abusing a different racket. So he'd have to change his grips and change the way he hit, struck the ball. And he'd be borrowing clothes from the lost and found and borrowing shoes that were too big or too little. So for him to be here on this day playing one of the greatest players of all time, that's just one of the great success stories in American tennis. In all of tennis. There's been some reverse engineering on some of his strokes, some of his grips.
You've got to be so careful when you come in on Nadal on that backhand side. His ability to defend aggressively off of it is uncanny. And remember, he's predominantly right-handed. So for him to execute that, it's a little easier than most. That was a thing of beauty. Tennis that he plays lefty. Everything else is righty. His golf swing, right's righty. Serve, isn't it? I bet you, if you're playing golf with him, you'd think, oh, he hasn't hit it that far, but just keep walking to his golf ball. He's one of those guys, you know. Sneaky good.
Latin. For service. Volte, 13.
Players get their own towels now. That rule instituted after COVID, but you'll see that time and again, the players will go to the towel box near their team. Get a little extra coaching, a little extra encouragement, as Rafa did just there.
Nadal. Nadal leads by 3 games to 2. First set.
Again, testimony to his ability to defend with his backhand. He's so intelligent. We saw the double-handed passing shot a couple of points ago. Now he's got the chip. I think that's been one of the biggest improvements in his game from when he first broke onto the tour. Well, he improved the backhand slice, the feel he's got with it, the bite that he gets with it. Oh, some good purchase on the court.
Coach Carlos Moya. The question he posed to Moya was, his U.S. Open debut was in 2003. His first title here was in 2010. And in 2022, he's going for his 23rd major. Which Nadal is better? Moya said, there are different eras. And the physical change is very big. In 2010, his game had some characteristics that he has lost because circumstances have forced him to make changes. But of course, to your point, he's also gained some things, like adding to his backhand, not having to run around his forehand so much. Moya goes on to say, if Rafa had continued playing like he did in 2010, he wouldn't be as competitive and possibly would have retired. Everyone on the team would love to have a fresh Rafa, 22 years of age, but we have to adapt to a body and a mind. He has things that are better than before, others that are worse. He's had to evolve to continue being competitive in 2022.
The
adaptability of the great athletes in any sport is something to behold, isn't it? Was the big talking point. He was crushing it, serving as big as he has ever done throughout the course of his career. First set percentage was down, but the points won behind the first had gone up very nicely, setting it flatter.
Regularly popping him into the 130s.
Yeah. Bennett, Tiafoe.
In the early years, beat Novak a couple of times in order to get his US Open crown, so testimony to how well he was playing on the hard courts.
Staying with Rafa.
Three games on. First set.
Come on, man. Come on.
That's a strong boy, is Francis Tiafoe. You can just see the muscles bulging there in his back.
He likes the gym.
Too.
Yeah, that's what I prefer.
Yeah,
he really has moved his toss over Nadal. You could really see it from here.
We are directly behind Nadal. Looking straight down the court.
Lower it to the left. Pitch so many balls, does he, in this match? He wants nice clean innings.
And it makes Love sense to have a lower ball toss, folks, because the higher the ball toss is, the more you're extending. And of course, with the tear in the abdominal, you know, you run the risk of doing more damage if you're extending all the time, for long periods of time. That's why he's chosen to go this route.
Tiafoe to go out for these serves.
only he could have that one back.
15-13.
He had left Nadal for dead. Nadal was covering the backhand down the line. Tiafoe was hitting the ball in the opposite direction, short to the forehand. Because that's what Nadal makes you do. Get that ball ever closer to the line. Because his movement is still so good. That's when you make errors. Put a little asterisk alongside that point. Difference between love 40 here. Last game with the old balls.
Those aren't raindrops.
New balls, please.
Tiafoe takes the lead in the opening set.
Tiafoe leads by 4-3. Thank you. Thank you.
I'd be fascinated to see how this game unfolds now that Tiafoe's got the break serving with new balls. How many first serve he makes in this game? Does he take a little bit off to make it, or does he continue to go for it?
Defense from Tiafoe till he found the net on that last stroke.
Tiafoe needs to up their first serve percentage. It's sitting at 35 right now. It's a failing grade in anyone's books. points for the second. Those do not come around every day of the week. Hasn't made a first serve in this game yet. Three tries, three fails. Get something that's short and central, they make you pay.
Bertion.
He's the one you practice with a coach. He feeds it slow, central. And you've got to hit those cones, Mary. Tight to the line, tight to the corner, short cross angle. Well, the way he spreads the court here is gorgeous. That forehand is sumptuous. I mean, the width and length, what a combo. Believe. Off his backhand side to hit this shot down the line.
Deuce.
Over the backhand side of right. I've seen him do it for 15 years. Get himself out of trouble with that shot. He's got such good feel on his backhand, Mary. He can defend, he can attack, mix it up with the slice. The guile with the lob, the accuracy of it.
Look, if you don't like it, you don't like it, Robbie. Just say it. Fourth ace for Tiafoe.
And then it's Tiafoe.
That's how good it's got to be.
Deuce.
I love the play. He's given himself a good chance of winning this point. Darnes guessed correctly.
Baseline against Nadal.
Tiafoe.
Just what Francis did to give himself another game point.
Yeah. The scary thing is that four winners in this game so far. Four good ones, right? Good winners. And it's still not over. That's how hard you got to work against Rafa. That's how good your level has to be.
Yeah. Oh!
Deuce.
I think this leave gives us an insight as to how he's feeling in this game. He's hoping that Nadal gives it to him rather than going out there taking it with the volley. Kenny Powers fast break.
Tiafoe.
His fifth ace.
That's got to be the fastest serve he's hit all match.
And Tiafoe.
The break to hold 5-3 for Francis Tiafoe.
Tiafoe leads by 5-3 first set.
It's a massive hole in the context of this opening set. The numbers don't lie. When you win the first set against anybody, your chances of winning the match go up significantly. I feel for Tiafoe, he needs to win this opening set a little more than Nadal has to.
Love 15.
Oh, now that's what we got, dude.
15 off. Thirty-15.
Yes. Met that as well as it could be met. This. The return gets the 24-year-old American within 2 points of the opening set. That's pretty good numbers from Tiafoe.
Okay.
He seems to be afraid of getting himself to the net on a big point.
Talk about the evolution in a player's game. It's another area where he's improved significantly. I mean, he regularly wins 80% and more points at the net His finishing volleys are good.
Game Nadal.
Nadal keeps it close.
Tiafoe leads by 5 games to 4.
Tiafoe will serve for the opening set.
First set. Thank you.
Tactics right out of the blueprint.
Third line.
You've watched the likes of Novak take on Nadal on a hard court. That is a shot he executes so well. That's why he's had so much success against him. Tiafoe's watch the tapes.
Back that return from Nadal, and now he has a 40-love game. Three set points.
First
double fault for Tiafoe. Let's see if it makes a difference.
Wait, please. Lucky for service.
Net as it made its way over. Tiafoe's
14-13.
One set point. They both take the time and towel off. And I could tell you that it is a packed house at the Junior Tennis Champions Center in College Park, Maryland. That's where Francis Tiafoe came out of, and where he's a hero to so many of the kids there. One more set point.
Please. Wait, please. 15 love. Go to love. Second service. Again, Nadal. First game. Second service.
He's got a lucky
water.
Towel?
That's from them. My water is the lemon one.
he's giving some direction to the ball guy.
¿Puedo cogerla?
Fifteen long. Go to love. Latin for service. Thirty-fifteen. 14-15. One game all, second set.
Un poc més agressiu, eh?
We're hearing both of Rafa's wrists were taped during that very long break, overlong break.
Venga,
confía, va.
Arfet, está mejor el clima, va.
Ahora mejor, ahora mejor.
Te recuperarás, vamos.
Rafael Maimo, his long-time physio with the last of Vamoses.
So it's long.
Has lost the opening set this week in two of the three matches he's played. So it's familiar territory. Read him like a book on this last
13-15.
Defense initially from Nadal was outstanding, but he loves this little flick cross court. He shapes like he's going to go down the line and then hits it cross court at the last minute. Catches so many guys out, but he ain't going to be catching out that man that is Tiafoe.
Tiafoe was smiling at Robbie as he hit it.
Yep. Got a sneaky feeling he knew it was coming. That's when you think to yourself, yep, homework has paid off.
Third service. Ball 15.
Set 2-1 in the second.
Leads by 2 games, 1 second set. First set, Tiafoe.
it's a dynamic duo, both of them. That's an excellent point you make, Mary.
15 block.
Not only having to deal with the occasion, but having to deal with what's Nadal. It's not easy. Especially when you haven't been in this position all that often. Sets they've played, Tiafoe hasn't been able to win a single one. So he's trending in the right direction.
Four to love. Forty, 15.
Another forehand.
And Tiafoe. Two games on.
That last one was something else.
Second set.
But he did not deviate on his part. He hit it early and hard.
Remember, you can download the US, download the US Open app and follow all the scores and the stats. Go to the App Store and Google Play Store, and you'll find out that Iga Świątek just took the second set against Jule Niemeyer, 6-4. So they go into a third.
Love. Go to lock. Go to lock.
Another forehand, really.
4-15.
He just catches it so early, doesn't he?
That was a compliment. backswing. Very little can go wrong. Nice bit of fade on it as well.
Again, Nadal. Nadal leads by 3 games, 2-2 second set. First set, Tiafoe. Thank you.
One of the biggest wins of James Blake's career was here when he upset Nadal in the third round of the 2005 U.S. Open. He's working for ESPN now, and Nadal came up to the studio after his win the other night. James Blake said, "We played each other 17 years ago, and you're still out there, and I'm up here." It's awesome. Later, another American trying to knock off Nadal.
Mm-hmm. 15 all.
Lost to too many Americans, Nadal, since October 2017, just one.
First service.
Against Americans since October of 2017 was Indian Wells final. It's Taylor Fritz, remember that?
Yeah, I sure do.
Earlier this year.
Fritz's biggest win, his first Masters 1000.
This
one has been perfect to that corner. He's mixed it up beautifully, occasionally going to the backhand side, but more often than not, dialed in on Rafa's forehand.
Balls, please.
Number seven from Francis Tiafoe. He's had five off
on
the backhand side, and he's had six aces.
Second set.
You wouldn't think after the way we watched Nick Kyrgios on this court last night, the way he played and won against Daniil Medvedev, that there wouldn't be that many winners left on this court. But there are.
I'll tell you, in his previous match against the Argentine Gregor Schwartzman, Tiafoe's run attack was in the 50s.
Yeah.
Excuse me, 45.
Yeah.
45 winners. In three sets, right? It wasn't like it was 4 or 5.
Fifteen love.
I tell you, you're 47 to win this in the match prior to that against Jason Kupler. Also three sets. Tight affair it was indeed. But, the winners have been raining from Tiafoe's racket.
15-love. Game, Tiafoe.
Come on.
The set four, game
ball, second set. Rafael Nadal has not yet earned a break point.
Here we go, vote!
Even though Tiafoe is serving at under 50%, he's winning about 80% of his first serves and about 90% of his second serves. Then that's his dad in the white shirt. Mom in the middle of the player box.
Appreciating the effort.
15-love.
He caught that clean.
He did.
strike off to the serve.
Though too long.
Such a good job of keeping his opponent under pressure. Saying to his team, what is a pickup? Shouldn't be picking it up that well.
How about the way Tiafoe's picking up the balls? The fact that he could even take a full swing, though he missed it on the run like that, after covering so much turf, just tells you how quick Tiafoe is.
Nadal's full serve contact height has gradually dropped from round to round. Definitely nursing the yab. A centimeter from round 1 to 2, and then 2 centimeters lower from round 2 to 3. To put that in perspective, his ball toss was about 10 centimeters higher in Australia than he won that major. So, spoken about the surf, this is a gilt-edged opportunity.
Thank you.
For Tiafoe here.
By 5-4, second set, first set, Tiafoe.
With Rafael Nadal just 4 points.
Thank you.
From evening this match. Winner here goes to the quarterfinal. Ace number 7. An hour. Oh.
just wide.
Wants
to see it. He felt good off his strings.
Same, a little concerned for Tiafoe in this game. You think that his first serve percentage for this set is 48. And he's winning 82% of the points behind the second serve. Those two numbers shouldn't coexist. He's left it. He's left the call, and nothing has been forthcoming. Licked the line.
Players are ready, thank you. Please. Thank you.
Just goes after it, he goes bigger when the pressure increases.
15-14.
After about an hour 45 without having a look at it, two break points for Rafa Nadal, two set points for the Spaniard.
Thank you.
Concentration from Tiafoe, because so easy to think this might have been a winner, but it comes back. Still work to do.
Players are ready, thank you, please. Thank you. Second set, Nadal. By 6-4, 1-0. Sit quickly.
All three, 23, all 23 Grand Slam titles and Serenas.
Another
American has already won on this court today, Jess Pegula. over Petra Kvitova, the top-ranked American woman, will probably finish this tournament landing in the top five in women's tennis.
Nice.
It's a good year.
Paul Tilla. Again, Nadal. First game, third set.
I guess Tiafoe had about 5 to 7 minutes to put the disappointment of that 10th game behind him. He's got to reset right now. Your ability as a tennis player to compartmentalize really comes to the fore now. Can you forget about what's happened? Just focus on the next point. It's one of the toughest things to do, but if you get it right, it's one of the greatest skills to have.
Isn't that something the guy on the other side of his net does well?
Quite well. Almost better than anybody who ever played the game.
If they
teach that to a young kid.
Isn't that what your buddy, Tiafoe's coach, has been trying to do with him? Got to stay focused. Obviously, the tennis comes in bursts, but you've got to be able to be ready when the next moment starts.
Paul Tillard.
Wayne Ferreira, as Mary is talking about, coach of Francis now.
Isn't that how Rafa practices?
Yep.
Ferreira wants to see Tiafoe do. Full focus, all in. No lapses.
Again, Tiafoe.
It's Kariccia. Told me a great story about the first time he hit with Nadal.
One game all.
He was one of the top players in the world at the time. And practice had been organized with Rafa. 15 years of age, came out there, and Alex fed the first ball nicely.
What does nice mean? Softly?
Softly. Mm-hmm. And Nadal just ripped it. First one right at him, and he kind of defended it, and he just ripped the second one straight at him, and he caught the ball, and he's like, Rafa, you know, take it easy. And Nadal's like, no, I must be focused from the very first shot, Alex. From the very first shot.
He's teaching the old guy how to do it.
Yeah. Love the thing.
Such an impression on Kariccia. Of course, now he sees the fruits of that labor, right? He's a commentator for Spanish TV. Watched him grow up, play against him, and now see him set records.
I
think Swiatek got herself out of real trouble against Jules Niemeyer and ended up winning it pretty quickly in the third.
Oh. 30-15.
Better forehand from Nadal.
40-15.
This is big time tennis. And always a barometer of Nadal's confidence. When he starts to leather that forehand down the line, you better watch out. That was as good as it gets.
Nadal leads by 2 games to 1 third set, 1-0.
Still a teenager. He'd be the youngest ever number one in the Open Era.
How about that?
He'd
be a party spoiler.
Go ahead, hoop me.
Nadal wins this match.
Okay.
That cannot happen.
Why did you do that? Here I am trying to big him up, trying to get everybody ready for the night match.
You were bringing the mood down a little earlier on.
Okay.
As possible for those fans watching at home. Yes, Rude and Alcaraz have got a chance to be number one. That really is dependent on Nadal losing today. If he wins, they're done and dusted.
All too long.
Spat back like that.
40-15.
Sooner rather than late at 40 love. Let Nadal hang around at your peril.
Then Tiafoe.
Oh.
game ball. Third set.
USOpenShop.org, as well as
thank you.
All the other stuff, the official shop. USOpenShop.org.
Fifth block.
Spicy, 20 miles an hour. Rhythm on serve in the set as Nadal has made 70% of those first serves. He's only lost 1 point behind his deal. Oh!
Dead.
I mean, the footwork to get around and rip that forehand. And he's got to generate all that pace himself. The ball was high and floating. So difficult to do.
Ball to 15.
I love the camera angle. A real feel for the shape of the ball. I remember when Philander played Linda in 88 final. And I remember watching the whole match from that camera angle. It must have been the camera angle of choice back in the day. Match brought out that backhand slice for five sets. That was the shot.
He won three of the four majors that year. Miss Wimbledon.
Again, Nadal. New balls, please. Nadal leads by three games to two, third set. Thank you.
Tiafoe is serving with new balls. I'm serving the third.
Latin. Good service. Love 15.
good as that approach was.
15 all.
Nadal wasn't far away from making that pass and making life very uncomfortable for the American.
Fourteen, 15.
He's really staying with Nadal, who, I mean, normally this is the point in a 3 out of 5
come
set
on,
match
come
where
on, guys, come on.
I think Nadal is going to really be going looking for some separation. But you can see from the attitude, the energy, the good play of Tiafoe that he's here till the very end. He still thinks he can beat this guy.
It's also helping that it's a little overcast. It's not too hot. There's definitely some humidity around. Tiafoe was struggling at the end of his match against Schwartzman. Even though it was just 3 sets, that was over 3 hours.
Being long. Fifteen all. 30-15.
Near misses in this game. Don't maxing out on time here. Discipline from him, huh?
30-14.
Fantastic.
First break he's earned since the opening set.
Players already, thank you. Thank you.
The body language from this 24-year-old American.
Stay active, Bo, here we go.
It's fun to watch.
Thank you.
Seen it, but the
love 15
clenched fist after this point. He knows he's got lucky, but he also understands the importance of that opening point. I mean, look at the athleticism of this guy. What a hustle. He knows he's back in business right there.
Ace number 10 for
15 all.
Perfect riposte.
Another 132 followed by 135.
30-15.
He said he was going to come at him, Tiafoe. That's what he's doing.
Oh. showing us he's no one-trick pony. What about the field?
14-15.
Pummeling a couple of forehands. And then just waving his wand. Oh, so gently. That was some Hogwarts stuff from Francis.
Serve it by, yeah. And it gets away with Tiafoe. It. It was just an 86-mile-an-hour serve, Robert. He came in behind it. And Nadal, well, he must have been expecting something bigger, right?
Tiafoe,
down the net.
Lead by five.
I don't think he expected him to serve.
Come on, Francis, come on.
That was the biggest surprise.
5-3 for Tiafoe.
And he just snuck up there on him.
He sure did. Well, if you serve 85 miles an hour, you're going to get pretty tight to the net for the volley. But he didn't even need one.
I know exactly what you mean. I can relate. The slowest winner that gets hit today.
15 all.
From the dollar this match, 105 miles an hour.
13-15.
Tiafoe looking for a backhand. He's got him with depth and direction. Good stuff.
Oh. 14-15.
So good at keeping his opponent on the move with his backhand. Shorter swing, takes time away, and he is deadly accurate.
Tiafoe leads by 5 games
Francis
to 4.
Francis Tiafoe is trying to serve himself into a 2-set-to-1 lead. I'll bet. Nori going down in straight sets.
Yeah.
Players are ready. Thank you. Thank you. Law 15.
That's how he ended the second set with that double fault that gave Rafa a 6-4.
Wait, please.
He's only had 3 in the match. 2 have come at terrible time. Not enough to erase the memory. 119-2. Unreturnable.
15.
He had a great serve, did Coach Ferreira. Unbelievable serve. He's dead.
Wait, please.
The way he holds his ground and can snap those deep shots back. Oh, how casually did he look at, have a look at the replay? I meant that. Sort of.
Yeah.
2 points from a 2-set-to-1 lead. From there.
How about that?
His 12 forehand winner gives him 2 chances to close out this set.
And that's that shuffle.
From the biggest win of his career.
By 6-4. Tiafoe leads by 2-1. Thank you.
with us.
Love
the end of the set. Just having a look how often Nadal has come back from two sets to one deficit at the hard court majors. It's happened on five occasions, but it's never happened here at the US Open. All five at the Aussie Open.
Tiafoe so quick, he very nearly got that in time to control the backhand line. How well he holds the court, Francis Tiafoe. Doesn't want to budge off that baseline. That's a nod of affirmation to the player box. A great point to start the fourth set.
Such an intelligent serve. Swinging lefty serve to right hand is forehand. If you don't make good contact, the ball just slides off your strings.
Nadal.
Puts you under so much pressure so easily.
first game for Sack. Sits quickly at the back of the court, please. The players are ready. Thank you.
We would never think that he is the one who's down two sets to one. Exquisite feel. That's one of the toughest things to do. Take pace off of a volley.
And Tiafoe.
And there is 14 for Tiafoe.
1 game all for
he is feeling it right now.
Thank you.
So many
Thank
times
you.
In this building, I've heard, let's go, Rafa. This time they're chanting, let's go, Francis. Why not? What a show they are both putting on.
Fifteen, No club.
Getting word that the roof is going to be closing again. Big delay at the start of the first match of the day out here, the women. Pegula through against Kvitova.
Ball to love.
It's Nadal's eighth ace. Against five double falls. Tiafoe's got 14 aces against three doubles.
Tear would affect his serve. He's made some adjustments to it, but he looks better now than he did in that opening set.
You can hear, if you listen carefully, you can hear that roof closing.
Chipping long.
There's always plenty of news around. Noise around here, Ronnie, whether it's airplanes or fans or everything else. I once heard Yvonne Lendl complain to the chair umpire because he didn't like the blimp noise. Now, I was here, and I looked up. I wasn't really hearing the blimp noise.
It is loud.
See that now? Tiafoe saying, so we're going to go right through the old roof closure? Blimp noise. Tell you what, once you are aware of it, you never forget it.
Absolutely. You can imagine. Are you quite good with noises? I am until I'm made aware of it.
I said
I'm terrible.
Okay.
If it was a world championships of sleeping, that would be one of the top two seeds.
Okay.
Oh, yeah.
In this game, that his fourth double fault.
Offer.
Swing at that at all. Big cut, he takes it. Catches it low on the racket. Low on the strings.
Thank you. Let's already play
for this fight.
Thank you.
Who do you like now?
It's
almost right up there with the Foster serve on the match. 138 from Tiafoe. What a time to bring the heat.
Another reminder about usopen.org. You can stay connected to this event on Facebook and Twitter, Instagram. All of it.
Congratulations.
Yeah, Tiafoe cursed up a storm right there. And Carlos Bernardes heard every bit of it.
Thank you. Love 15.
Seventh double fault for Nadal. Again, because of the tear in his ab, he has decided to throw his toss a little bit lower. Carve around it more. An ab tear, it's easy for that thing to spring back up on you.
Yeah, he's about 10 centimeters lower with the contact point.
That's good. Right behind Tiafoe.
There he was in Australia, folks.
15 on.
From one lefty to another, Ben Stiller, big fan of Raffles. This is my co-commentator. Southpaw.
Okay, 15.
this match.
34-2.
Tiafoe's 2-3 in break chances.
By 3 games to 2 for sets. Tiafoe leads by 2 sets to 1.
That's the one thing about Nadal, he doesn't get down on himself when he gets broken. He knows he will create opportunities. He's well aware of the effect that he has on opponents. One thing, chasing. It's a different thing altogether when you're in the lead. Like Tiafoe is 2 sets to 1. And serve here. Suddenly the pressure shifts to the American side of the court. Tiafoe lost in Washington to Nikiraz. Had 5 match points there. Of course, in Canada against Fritz, he was 4-love up in the deciding set and let that one get away. So being a front runner is a lot tougher than what many people might think.
Dallas
book with the forehand.
Oh, wow.
Deuce. Advantage, Tiafoe.
I'm just so impressed with Tiafoe and how he has handled himself. Coach Wayne Ferreira has got to be admiring what his young charge has been able to do. So often when Tiafoe has played, because he's got so much energy and so many shots and loves to showboat, he has tried to win the moment. Now he's trying to win the match.
Love 15.
Tiafoe on a couple of occasions with that serve, slightly quicker, 108 miles an hour to the forehand body. Just aims at that right pocket.
Four of his nine double faults have come in set four.
Deuce.
piece of art right there. Are you going to compare it to some piece of art?
Advantage.
Come on, say it, Bobby, say it. I know you want to.
What a stroke.
What a spot.
Please.
Yeah. Didn't have a lot of room to make good a shot.
Showing us how good the feel was there.
Deuce.
Coming off of Carlos Costa gets out of his seat. Second row there. Rafa's agent, of course, former player, top tenner.
At Bennett, Tiafoe.
Tiafoe's 3 of 5.
Leads by 4 games to 3, 4 sets, and by 2 sets to 1.
And that was here, second round U.S. Open, 17 years ago.
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen, the players are ready. Thank you.
Talking about it, a major, of course. 17 years ago. That's a long time between drinks.
Speaking of 3 points, he's defied the odds there. Was Tiafoe.
Wait, please.
According to the numbers in this set, he had a 27% chance of winning the point behind a second serve.
And rope of a forehand. Boom! 15 of them.
He's just been brave in this game from the ground, because I tell you what, he hasn't served particularly well. He's entered a lot of second serves in this game. It'll do his confidence the world of good to close out the service game here and now. That's a first serve. That's intelligent tennis from Rafa. Just keeping the ball low. Giving Tiafoe no pace to work with.
Looking at the court, there are some funky bounces on this
court.
Thank you. But that leaky backhand of his brings us back to deuce.
Number 17.
Advantage, Tiafoe.
What a timely ace. Can't be passive. You have got to go out there and win it. That's what happens. Just put balls in the court, and they will make you pay. That was a classy point from the American.
He went big.
And Tiafoe.
4 points away.
Tiafoe leads by 5-3, first set.
Well, it's worth remembering that Tiafoe is trying to do something that hasn't been done in a long time. The last time Nadal suffered a loss in a completed match at a major. You've got to go back to Roland Garros 2021. And Djokovic beat him there in the semi-finals.
Thank you, Nathan.
See, this is when all the kids move down. They try to get down to the court with their oversized balls and to get them signed. And this is when the ushers have to really ush.
Take any seat for now, please. Thank you. Love 15.
Glued that to Nadal's shoelaces.
Please, thank you.
Match points all over this house.
Please. Fifteen-14.
Feel it, kid. Oh, this is some moment, huh? One of the most liked players in both locker rooms comes up with an historic win.